Welcome to this video series on undirected network models. In this video series, I'll explain about undirected network models, what they are, where they come from, and I'll give a bit of the basics on how to estimate these undirected network models. In the next video series, we'll go on with more advanced methods of estimating undirected network models, including model selection, so which edges are there or not, testing for accuracy, stability in your network, and also comparing networks. So after these two sessions, you'll be able to estimate network models and pretty much do most of the things that you see that are being done now in the literature. So to start with a bit of a spoiler, the codes actually really are not that hard. So mostly for this session, if you understand these few lines of codes, when you load the package and you do run estimate network from the bootnet package, then you can already estimate a network model. Then all you need to do is change the default here to something, and we'll explain that. And then you already have a network model. There are some other codes you can use, some other packages you can use, and I'll go a bit over them as well. But this is one of the main lines of codes you see used now to estimate a network model. Then for the next session, to do bootstrapping and stability and accuracy checks, that's just, for example, these two lines of codes where we run bootnet. And then we can compare networks with this line of code here with NGT from network comparison. And there are also some other methods for that. So if you know these codes, you can actually do already a lot of the network analysis that you see being done in the literature. Now, of course, the code might be relatively easy, but you need to understand what's in the box, what's happening behind the screens here. So that's the point of this video series and also the next one to give you a more detailed idea about what's happening. So in this video, I'll talk a bit about models and software. And mainly I'll discuss two types of models. I'll discuss the Gaussian graphical model, which is a parse correlation network, where all the edges represent parse correlations. And I'll discuss the Ising model, which is also an undirected network, but for binary data. And this comes from physics, where it's used to model magnets. I'll also mainly talk about two software packages. I'll talk about the bootnet package, which is a big wrapper package that has default sets for all kinds of other packages that you can use to make the code more easy. And I'll talk about the psychonetrics package, which is a relatively new package that I made that you can use for maximum likelihood estimation of networks. I'll also talk a bit about something that's very new, which is called BGGM or Bayesian graphical Gaussian graphical models for Bayesian estimation. So the main question of this series of lectures is, what is the structure of psychology? So how do we go from data to a network structure? Right, and usually we have observed data, like cross-sectional data. This could also be time series data, but we'll talk more about that in a later lecture as well. Now, to briefly follow up on the previous lecture on causality, you can also try to estimate directed networks, right? We'll talk more about this in a later video in much more detail. So I only have one slide on this now, but this is mainly to explain the bridge from causality to undirected networks. So these directed networks or DAGs are very powerful tools for confirmatory testing. So if I have a theory, so maybe I have this theory, then I can actually fit this, for example, in the structural equation model, get fit indices, things like that. And then we can see if our model fits the data very well. And there are also several estimation tools that you can use to try to estimate this kind of structures from data. So for example, the PC-ELK or the BNLearn packages are very strong in trying to recover this from data. Actually, this is an example of a BNLearn algorithm. However, there are quite some problems also with DAG estimation. It's not very trivial. Mainly, we need to assume that the data, the model is acyclic. That might be a very hard thing to do because you might easily think of cyclic relationships or like A cos B, also B cos A. The directional effect is very hard to estimate usually. So usually A causes B is not statistically different from A is caused by B, and if it is, so maybe there's like some C here which makes this path identified, then they might still not be very clearly separable. So you might still get like an edge, but in the wrong direction of effect that you would expect. And you also have the problem of many potentially equivalent models. So already here, you see that these two are equivalent. If you increase the number of variables, you get more equivalent models, right? Many more equivalent models. So these are all examples of equivalent models that are directed acyclic graphs. So instead of estimating directed networks, we have moved to estimating undirected networks. And these undirected networks are a very powerful tool that you now see quite often used in the literature, especially when people are using network analysis. In an undirected network is called a Markov random field. And for binary data, this is called an Ising model or an Ising model. And for continuous data that's normally distributed, like that, it's called the Gaussian graphical model or partial correlation network. I'll talk a bit more about this assumption of normality in a later video as well. The edges in an undirected network model show conditional dependencies. So that means that this edge between two variables here shows the association that's left after conditioning or controlling for all other variables in the network. And in the Gaussian case, that's actually a partial correlation. And there are some really useful properties to undirected network models. For example, you don't have this problem of identification. These are actually uniquely identified. So that means that there are no two equivalent models unless you start introducing latent variables. They're very powerful estimation procedures because of this as well. Because you have this unique identification, you can do very easy model search strategies where you add, remove edges until you get an optimal fit. And you can very easily weight the edges. So here you see these weights, right? Some edges are stronger than others. These come very clearly out of the models. There's usually one clear square matrix that you can use as a weight. In directed networks, this is not as clear. So A causes B and B causes A might be equivalent. But if you put a regression weight on here, this regression weight might be different. So it's not really clear what the weight would be from an undirected edge there. There are also many different algorithms to estimate this network. And the downside is that there's not really one clear-cut winner that always works best. So there are cases when not one algorithm works best, there are cases when another algorithm works best. And we'll teach you about many different ways in which you can estimate these kinds of models. Now, we've mainly seen these models used in cross-sectional data, where you have one observation per person. So this is a picture of a paper by Don Robinow, where you see the amount of papers published using network methods. And clearly, the pairwise Markov random fields here is the one that got the most publications. So it's a very popular tool now. And these have mainly been used in cross-sectional analysis. That doesn't mean necessarily that you cannot use this in time series, because you can use it in time series. But in time series analysis, you have temporal dependencies, so we can do more in time series analysis. And that's what we'll talk about also in a later video, where we extend the Gaussian graphical model with temporal effects so that we can use them in time series as well. All right, that's it for this introduction video on undirected network models.